Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Faizullah and you are watching Easy Mathematics. In this video, we shall learn that what are exact differential equations and how to solve them. Exact differential equations. Let us start from the definition. We say that a differential equation of the form 1 is exact if left hand side of this equation is a total differential of some function. Note that we denote the coefficient of dx by m and the coefficient of dy by n. Let us explain it by some examples. Example number one. X dy plus y dx is equal to zero. Is it an exact differential equation or not? So we can see that this equation or the left hand side of this equation can be written as d of xy is equal to zero. Because if we use the product rule and evaluate this, again we get the left hand side of the given equation. So we can see that the left hand side of this equation is a total differential of the function xy. So this implies that equation 2 is exact. Let us see another example. 2xy dx plus x square dy is equal to zero. Is it an exact differential equation or not? So from here we can write that this is d of x square y is equal to zero. Because again, if I evaluate this by the product rule, I can get the left hand side of equation 3. So we can see that the left hand side of equation 3 is a total differential of x square into y. And this implies that 3 is exact. Criteria for exact differential equation. We say that a differential equation of the form m dx plus n dy is equal to zero is exact if and only if my is equal to nx, or we can write by my we mean partial differentiation of m with respect to y, and nx mean partial differentiation of n with respect to x. So if we are given a differential equation of this form, we shall partially differentiate m with respect to y and n with respect to x. If these two are equal, we will say that the given equation is an exact differential equation. Let us explain it by some example. Example number one, in which we have x dy plus y dx is equal to zero. Here the coefficient of dx is m, which is y, and the coefficient of dy, which is n, and here it is x. So let us differentiate m with respect to y, we get 1, and to differentiate n with respect to x, we get 1. So we can see that my is equal to nx, which is equal to 1. And this implies that this equation number 2 is exact differential equation. So throughout this course, we shall use criteria for exact differential equation to determine whether the given differential equation is exact or not. Method of solutions for exact differential equations. If we are given an ordinary differential equation of the form 1 and we prove that it is exact, it means that if we prove that my is equal to nx, then equation 1 can be solved as follows. We shall integrate m with respect to x, but keeping y as constant. Plus we shall integrate only those terms of n which are free from x with respect to dy is equal to c. C is a general constant. Let us explain this method by solving some problems. Question number 1. Solve the ordinary differential equation number 3. So here m is the coefficient of dx, which is 3x square y plus 2, and n is a coefficient of dy, which is x cube plus y. Let us partially differentiate m with respect to y. So we have 3x square. And now let us partially differentiate n with respect to x. So we have 3x square. Now from here we can see that my is equal to nx, which means that the ordinary differential equation number 3 is exact. Now to solve this differential equation, we shall use the procedure given by 2. According to this integral, we can write m is 3x square y plus 2 into dx. But I will write here that y is constant in this integral. Plus, we shall integrate only those term of n which are free from x. So there is only one term which has no x, and that is y. So I will integrate y with respect to y equal to c. And if I integrate the first term by keeping y as constant, I get 3x cubed divided by 3y plus 2x plus y square divided by 2 is equal to c. And now if I simplify this, I will get that this is x cubed y plus 2x plus y square divided by 2 is equal to c. And that is the required solution for this problem. Question number 2. Determine whether the differential equation number 1 is exact or not. If it is exact, solve it. To show that the given equation is exact, here m is the coefficient of dx, which is equal to y cos x plus 2x e power y, and n is equal to sine x plus x square e power y minus 1. Now we have to partially differentiate m with respect to y, which gives cos x plus 2x e power y. And now we have to differentiate n with respect to x. We get cos x plus 2x e power y. And we can see that my is equal to nx. This implies that equation number 1 is exact. Now, to solve this equation number 1, we know the procedure that we shall integrate m with respect to x, keeping y as constant. Plus, we shall integrate those terms of n which are free from x with respect to y equal to constant. So according to this procedure, let us integrate m, which is cos x plus 2x, sorry, it's y cos x plus 2 x e power y into dx. And we shall write y constant. Plus, let us write those term of n which are free from x. So there is only one term, which is minus 1. Into dy is equal to c. And now let us solve this equation. So y is constant. Differentiation of sine is cos. So integration of cos is sine. Plus e power y. Y is constant. So we have to write 2x squared divided by 2 e power y. And this is minus y is equal to c. If we further simplify this, we get y sine x plus x square e power y minus y is equal to c. And that is the required solution. Question number 3. Solve the differential equation number 1 with the given initial condition number 2. To solve this differential equation, here m is equal to 2x y minus 3 and n is equal to x square plus 4y. Now let us partially differentiate m with respect to y. We have 2x. And if we partially differentiate n with respect to x, we get 2x. So we can see that my is equal to nx. This implies that equation 1 is exact. Now to solve equation number 1, we use the procedure that integration of m with respect to x, keeping y is constant, plus integration of those terms of n which are free from x. which has no x, dx dy is equal to c. From here we get integration, and the value of m is 2xy minus 3 into dx, keeping y is constant, plus those term of n which are free from x. So we can see there is only one term of n which is free from x, and that is 4y into dy is equal to c. Now to evaluate this integral, we have 2x squared divided by 2y minus 3x plus 4y squared divided by 2 is equal to c. If we further simplify this, we get x square y minus 3x plus 2y square is equal to c. In the next step, we need the value of this general constant c. So we have to use the initial conditions. From 2, we have the initial conditions y of 1 is equal to 2, which means that at x is equal to 1, the value of y is 2. Therefore, putting x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2 in equation number 3, we have, so x is 1, y is 2, we will get 2 here. Now here x is 1, so we get minus 3 plus 2, and y is 2, 2 2's are 4. So we have 4 here is equal to c, which if we simplify, we get that c is equal to 7. Therefore, equation number 3 becomes, therefore, 3 becomes x square y minus 3x plus 2y square, and the value of c is 7, and that is the required solution. That's all.